How can something small have an impact of great magnitude? It is May of 1998, and beachgoers along the California coast are noticing a disturbing trend. California sea lions are showing up sick and stranded, or even worse, dead. The animals appear to be in good physical condition, with no injuries, adequate blubber thickness, and regular blood samples. By all normal measures, the sea lions possess immaculate health. But the sea lions that are found alive exhibit a set of disturbing symptoms: seizures, head scratching and head weaving, lack of muscle control, and eventual coma. Over the course of 1 month, 400 deceased sea lions wash ashore, and 70 sick individuals are transported to the Marine Mammal Center in the hope of saving the animals and discovering the cause of the mysterious deaths. The public is perplexed over the seemingly unexplainable illness. As scientists at the Marine Mammal Center work to investigate the condition of their patients, they notice that all of the deceased sea lions exhibit lesions in the brain, a shrinking of the hippocampus, the portion of the brain responsible for learning and memory. The lesions are reminiscent of a frightening illness: poisoning by domoic acid, a deadly neurotoxin. It also explains the head scratching, a behavior previously observed in pelicans exposed to domoic acid. But how were the sea lions exposed to domoic acid? Introducing Pseudo-nitzschia australis, a type of microscopic phytoplankton that produces domoic acid. How can something so small have such an impact? The short answer is that there are a lot of them. 130,000 of them per liter of ocean water, to be exact. Scientists determined that an algal bloom from the same month as the sea lion mortality event could explain the concentration of domoic acid in the sea lions. Warm coastal waters create the perfect conditions for such a bloom. Fish are tested to reveal a high accumulation of domoic acid, meaning that sea lions are being poisoned by their own prey. By the middle of June, only a month after sick sea lions began appearing on beaches, the last report of a sick sea lion comes in. Researchers find that the density of algae in the water has significantly decreased, and with it, the high concentration of domoic acid. Some sea lions in care at the Marine Mammal Center are able to be saved by flushing out the toxin and consuming toxin-free fish. But many wonder what will prevent such an occurrence from happening again. Their concerns prove valid, as in the years following the 1998 mortality event, similar instances of harmful algal blooms leave marine mammals stranded and sick. Though scientists like those at the Marine Mammal Center continue to strive for a better understanding of the causes of harmful algae blooms, one thing is certain: that warmer waters provide the ideal conditions for these dire circumstances, and warmer waters are an ever-increasing reality for the world's oceans, unless steps are taken to reduce the speed and intensity of climate change, the kinds of steps that can only be achieved through the voices of a great number of informed individuals. The work of the Marine Mammal Center is funded in large part by small donations. Small donations that add up and make it possible for sick sea lions to be rehabilitated and further research to be done on current threats to marine life, like domoic acid. So how can something small have an impact of great magnitude? In short, if there is a lot of them.